Welcome back to my Let's Play of Hedon. Hedon. As she waddled through a cloud of dust and rubble, they noticed an already familiar presence waiting at the end, a ruined corridor. She ran towards it, but much to her expectations, the dark creature vanished into thin air, leaving a puff of black smoke behind. A series of curses echoed the plaza's caverns as Zane proceeded toward the park, her axe up and ready. How is she supposed to fight this dark thing after all? It always seemed to guide her towards more danger. Alas, the park greets her with the sound of restless insects and the dark chill of what may lie ahead. When I was told I would be expected to welcome party here, I assumed they would be alive. How hard it can be to overcome a few measly orcs. Yeah, at least the fumes come from the incompetent bodies should help silence these maddening crickets outside. I must get to work. Cremating the dead was not my duty. I've already discovered a message left behind by an ID survivor. I do believe she's still alive and bent on slowing down her advance at any cost. I must inform Mistress Mithril as soon as I can. Am recalled. This reaver also mentioned crystals in her note, so the ID must be somewhat aware of our purpose here. I will commence my research on the crystal heart right now, but it'll be harder without assistance. The plaza seems devoid of any life, yet I feel unsafe. Rumor has it that Half-Blood has vanished from the battlefield. Nobody could find her corpse. But I worry too much. It's not like she would just barge in the... I've been doing my best to hamper the sudden invasion from the shadows. The ventilation shaft helped me move around unseen. I have overheard the cultists getting orders to blow up the cave and the exits. They're locking down the entire stronghold. Nonetheless, I have managed to get inside the crystal shop and move all the merchandise upstairs. Must but delay them from getting their hands on our tech. Power cores. But they heard the noise, so I had to break the ladder and go. Luckily, I found a warning thrown. That's the same. Sort of. realize I've had this key on me since yesterday. I'm ringing for the council. Can you be kind and return this portal key for me? I promise, girls. It's Gold's. You tell her it's my fault and I appreciate it. Did I ever pick that up? Pretty sure I ever picked it up. Or did I die before I picked it up? Money. What the hell? The cultists, they somehow corrupted the portal. This black slime, what the hell is this? Back at the forge, we stepped in right after Dura and the others. But then, this flash of light and something felt so off with the portal. The next we woke up in the grove. Arva and what's left of me, the gateways closed up. Suddenly, and sliced my light clean off. I'm done for. Arva left to search for the key to turn the thing back on, but she's been away for too long now. I can at least pray Dura and what's left of the squad have better luck than us. Come on. Come get me to send me back to the pits of hell. of metal and cave rock, the study by Earth Mother Bendy. Today I have witnessed a first working crystal grown by ancestral magic. The seed is finally able to grow a fully edible vegetable crystal instilled with healing powers. The testing has been completed with favorable results. As long as we don't remove the stem from the soil, luckily for us, we still have 18 days until the campaign begins. I have made my arrangements for a reaver team to go forth and spread the crystal plant seed ahead of our future path. With a bit of luck, we'll be able to reap the healing pods just as we are making our advance toward the accursed fire pits of hell. Make sure to turn auxiliary power on before you shut down the generator for any maintenance work. I don't want to hear any more complaints from the archive curator getting stuck in their office because doors stop working. Just talk to the Earth Mother to let her in the portal cave until we get our own bind keys.
Thank you.
Oh. I know there's water in here. I wonder if I could have just flooded them. The demon blood lives, and she is here. She slaughtered our entire force in the plaza, and knowing how competent our worshippers have proven themselves to be so far, I'm certain that she's making her way towards our goal. Do not let her reach the portal here. Reinforce the main gates. Have a barricade built. Send the strongest of your iron mains to hold that line. Should they fall, the half-blood will meet her end before she reaches the portal. dealt with the last intruder, she's managed to get all the way up to the second floor, but she couldn't get past the roof gate. Still, neither can we. We've tried everything but the roof. We know we've used a table or such spells to grant them passage, but the guarding the library must have hidden the tablet before we got here. Whatever lives on the floor above it must be valuable to them. Perhaps this very rare key to be portal controlled. Nobody else has sound, alright? We need to find that darn tablet. I need aid. Greenskin couldn't have had much time to hide the tablet after hearing a word. To no avail, I need you to send more thralls here so it can't cover Morgan. of this game's definition of a boss fight. Just spew a thousand enemies and don't die. Yeah, that's great game design. Anyways, so hey, that's it for this episode. Thanks for watching. Bye.